Well, hello, and welcome to episode 71 of Aftershock Weekly. This week, I want to talk to you about some big changes that Google are making with Google AdWords. They've now changed the name to Google Ads, and they've changed their interface completely. Now, it's been very confusing for a lot of marketers that work in our industry, going in and looking at a brand new interface. So about a year ago, they rolled it out, and they gave me the option to go back to the current interface. But now that they've officially switched their name over to Google Ads, and their interface is here to stay, I'm gonna walk you through a quick tutorial to show you where to find some of the things that you easily found before. And I'm gonna show you some cool features that it has. So here we go.
Okay. Here we are in the new AdWords interface. You'll notice a lot of style changes. It's a dark gray now instead of that light gray that they had forever. But the big things that we'll start out by pointing out, they moved the top level navigation, the tabs that they used to have at top. They now put those over on the side here. So here's your campaigns at a glance. If you are running shopping or display ads, it'll actually have a tab that'll say search, display, and shopping, so you can actually just show those campaigns. Over here are access within your campaigns to all the different areas that you had before on the sub-level navigation, but let's go ahead and click on campaigns. So see here, campaigns, it'll bring up the different campaigns we're using, but if I were to click up ad groups, it'll pull up each ad group within each one. Ad extensions, you can dive down from the campaign level if you want to look at ad extensions. You can do that here. And they grouped ads and extensions in one tab. So you'll see here is where you navigate to that. So they're no longer separate. So here you'll see extensions built out. Change history has also been moved down here. So here's our change history, and if we were to do all time, show the different changes that were made to this particular account. Now that's convenient because it used to be a little hidden, so it's there. But now let's say that we want to dive into an ad group. Up here you're going to notice that it trails or gives you breadcrumbs to where you're at in the campaign. So for easy access, if you want to go to the top levels, you can hover over and then simply go back to Miami or all campaigns. All right. Your settings for each campaign are also going to be in this column over here. This is where you set your daily budget, your bidding strategy. This is also where you would select where you're going to show the ads and locations. Most of this didn't change. It's the same thing. So if you want to click on advanced search, you'll have a location and a radius. So they did take away tabs. Similar, they just changed the format. It used to be up here in tabs. They simplified it, which is definitely nice. Now, one thing that they took directly from Facebook, so it seems, so if you go up here to the tools area, they've laid out in columns the different areas you would want to visit, right? And they've categorized, they got planning, shared library, bulk actions, measurement, setup. So in your planning, this is where your keyword planner and your ad preview and diagnostics are now. Your shared library, so this is where you can create audiences for retargeting, portfolio bid strategies, negative keyword lists. Negative keyword lists, if you're not familiar with it, is a great way to create one list and then you can associate it to multiple campaigns at the same time rather than doing it just at the campaign level and having to copy and paste over and over. Shared budgets, placement exclusion lists, then they have the bulk actions, rules, scripts, uploads, measurement, you know, things like your conversions. Conversion tracking has changed. It now requires two bits of script. They used to have it to where you could use Tag Manager as an option, and you would have one universal code in Tag Manager, and then you would put a script of what page you want to track or what action. But now, like if we were to click on this here, go to Tag for New Lead, say we want to add it ourselves, you're going to notice that we have this top tab that has to be, it's a global tag manager, and this is going to be site-wide, and then you say, this is where I want to track my event. So let's say it's a thank you page. You would put this on the thank you page. Or if you want it to be on click, you want to see when somebody clicks a button or somebody clicks on a phone call, you would put this on that page and it'll start tracking that clicks. So that has changed, and make sure you include this top script. So back to tools. Then you have your setup where your billing and your payment, business information, linked accounts. And if you want to go back, they've made a nice handy little arrow here that will take us back to the campaign level. And if we want to go back to all of the accounts that we have, if you have an MCC, you would just simply click on the drop down, and in our case it's Aftershock Enterprises, and it'll bring us back to all of the accounts we have, right? Lastly, I want to show you a few of the areas that have changed when it comes to looking at the key performance indicators. Let's say, for example, we go into the Miami section, and you're going to see this filter here. This filter is going to show you what ad groups are showing. So you have all enabled, or all but removed. So if you have all enabled, these are the ones that aren't paused. This is similar to what they used to have in AdWords, but they did move everything over here. Now let's say we want to segment by different things like time or conversions or click type. You can do that here with columns. It used to be customized columns. Now you can go to columns and they have modify columns, which will give you all your KPIs, but they know that conversions is something that most people want to add if it's not already there. So they've made that simple right here. Here's where your download section is. This is something when they first rolled it out, they didn't have, which was kind of funny, but this is where you would download any sort of spreadsheet that would show you metrics of how a campaign is performing. Over here and more, take advantage of the paste. So let's say you wanted to copy an ad group and you didn't have this selected. So you would either need to check over here, or you would need to go over to the paste area.
I hope that tutorial was informative and that you learned some things, because this is a huge change that they've made, but I will tell you, the tool has become even more powerful. It's a big, big interface, and if you're running your own campaigns, there's a lot of things that you can do to optimize and make your campaigns perform better. So if you don't want to run your own campaigns, you can always call us and we'll take care of you. But thanks for tuning in today. We look forward to seeing you next week.